I feel like I wanna go home, but I am home, and the cold and the cold sound lonesome and mad from the walnut tree, the flowers you planted. And I hear they shiver, saying in paper as the wind comes through whistling.
Mafia. Okay. Oh my goodness, golly gosh, guys. It is time to be live. Listening to some smooth jazz. Where's the jazz? There's the jazz. And we are live. Oh my god. I didn't think my room was gonna look that bad, like on camera, but it is that bad. Okay, that's really depressing. And apparently you can't hear the jazz music all that well. I'm gonna turn down my microphone. This is depressing. Okay, that seems like a solid, like, thing to do. We've got some jewelry on today because of what we're going to be doing. And I'm going to push my hair back because it'd be like that. Nah, it looks better when I do it like this. So, for shits and giggles, I wanted to do, like, a just chatting stream. Okay, sorry. I'm like shaking my leg under the table and I wanted to see if it was like ricocheting off the mic. Because I didn't want it to sound like this the entire time. And my chair is too close to my PC. Yesterday I got jump scared by a bug trying to film a reaction video to Sam and Colby content. They're going to be relevant today as well. Oh, damn. Sorry, Kit is giving me updates on their New York trip currently. So, what was I saying? Ah, I got jump scared by a bug yesterday. I have the video and I'm probably gonna play it on stream because I think it's funny. So, I'm currently armed with a vacuum. Damn, that's like the grossest thing I've ever seen. I'm armed with a vacuum. Sorry, some dust came flying at me. Because last time I saw it, I mean, it's not something I'm typically scared of. Like, this kind of bug, I don't really care for. It was just so big that I was like, you know? Like, I was like, oh my god. Yeah, but I should be okay. I haven't seen it in a while, which is good. But at the same time, not good, because that means I don't know where it is. But it's one of those, like, weird, like, quadruple winged fat little things that scared the shit out of me. So I'm gonna post that video as well, and I need to post it. I'm waiting to post it later tonight, because if I post it later tonight, then I will, why did that go down? Okay, then I will, I'm trying to angle it to where, like, if you post it at a specific time, like, it's more likely to get views. Because it's not the longest video, but it's not the shortest video either. And, just by experimenting, like, posting, like, 2, 3, 4 second, 5 second videos, they tend to get way more views because of how short they are, that you just replay. Especially if there's, like, long text in the video itself, because nobody sits around and watches like a 3-minute video unless it's like South Park, which I've been trapped into doing. Also, the reason my room looks the way that it does is because my brother is moving back in with us, because he got a job close by, so he's gonna be moving back in with us. And so I have to take all of my shit out of the closet because he's getting my old room. And yeah, so yeah. That's really all my life updates. So for stream today, what I'm thinking on doing is I got the bright idea. So I've recently gone through and burned through all of my what is it called, all of my Life of Luxury content. Like, I am waiting for them to upload, because I know that the production time and, like, post-edit and, like, post-production is what it's called, take a long time to do. And so, I'm waiting for them to upload so I can, like, eat it up, you know? And I'm currently, in the meantime, watching Sam and Colby, which is, like, so ironic. Considering I used to watch Sam and Colby all the time when I was younger. Like, I watched them before they got arrested, and I remember I stopped watching them because my parents didn't like Sam and Colby because of the dangerous activities that they did, which was investigating abandoned buildings. Well, it didn't really help. I'm still into that stuff. Like, I'm literally going ghost hunting next Sunday. Like, I'm going to a graveyard, going ghost hunting, going to a haunted antique shop, going to a graveyard, doing the SS method, like, the whole nine yards. Because I don't really consider myself a psychic per se, but I do consider myself to have some form of psychic ability, because, like, it's one of those, like, nonchalant ones that it's gotten, like, more in tune recently for whatever reason. And it's one of those, like, you wake up and you're like, damn, today's gonna be weird, and then the day's weird. Or, like, you wake up and you're like, damn, the fuck does that mean? And then that thing happens. Or it's you walk into a building and you're like, damn, the fuck going on in here? I do that all the time. Like, we'll walk into a building and I'm like, damn, the fuck going on in here? Because there's two antique stores that I love. The first one that is haunted, like there was something in there. I have a crazy story for. And the second one, they have a little cat. I forgot the cat's name. Bella. It's like Miss Bell. I think they call her Miss Bell. Because I think her full name is like Anna something Bell. Anna Marie Bell, something like that. But they just call her Miss Bell. And she's like the resident cat. And then the graveyard. Okay, that's not relevant to the story quite yet. We'll get there. So the first one that's haunted, I've only gone there three times in my entire life because my mom doesn't like going there, and I only go there because it is interesting to me because it's haunted. Now, I don't know if haunted would be the right word for this, like, particular instance, because there's something there, and it's mean, because you walk in, and you dread, heaviness, you can't breathe. Like, I get sick in that building. Like, the floor, I can't tell if it's because of the floors, or if it's because of the energy, or if it's like a combo move of both, but when I go to that building, I get fucking tilted. Like, I get vertigo in that building. And I also get vertigo in the second shop, but that's because of the floors. Hold on. There's something in my mask. It's bothering me. I think it's a cat hair. Okay, I should be okay. Okay. Well, in the first shop, the one that, like, makes me sick, it has something mean in there, and I can't tell if it's the house, if it's the lady that works there, if it's something in the house that resides, but it's mean, and I don't mean, like, demonic, I just mean, like, whoever lived there in the past, because this is, like, a house turned antique store in, like, a really old part of, old part of town, like, 30 minutes out from where I live. And you walk in, and it's, like, it's mean in there. And I don't know how else to put it. It's, like, it's weird. And you walk in, and I get the sense of dread. Like, not really dread, per se, but it's definitely off-putting. Like, it's an uneasy feeling. Is the best way to put it. It's not dread, but it's not anything good, you know? And you walk in, you feel like you can't breathe. I feel like I can't breathe. Like, it's just so heavy. It's, like, physically dense. And it's, like, it's hard to breathe in there. It's really heavy, just, like, on the soul and physical body. Like, it feels like you're wading in water. Or, like, trying to walk underwater is what it feels like, almost. And then, like I said, I get nauseous in there. Like, I feel like I get vertigo, like, that, as soon as I walk in. Like, it's so bad. And then, the reason, that's, like, why this place is, like, ooh, you know? And my mom, she's the same way. She doesn't like it in there. My nan doesn't like it in there either. And so, my inquotation scary experience with that is the last time we went, which won't be my final time. My final time is probably going to be Sunday. Next Sunday, not this Sunday, because this Sunday is Easter. The last time I went, I was wearing my rosary. This is the rosary. You're not supposed to wear these, I figured out. Because apparently it's, like, a cardinal sin, which I think is weird. Why wouldn't you wear it? Like, it's literally a necklace. So, I wear this for several different reasons, because I'm not Christian. I'm, agnostic is what it's, like, officially called. So I wear this for my own sense of protection, like for my own God. This belongs to my God, not the Christian version. And so I wear this for him. And I was wearing my rosary. I was decked out in like all of my jewelry, and I'm not decked out in all of my jewelry today, just what I thought I would need for what I'm gonna do, which is my obsidian ball necklace and then my rosary, because you know, Jesus. And then we have an obsidian ring, and we have, I think this is tiger's eye obsidian, and I'm not sure what this one is, but it's basically like a ward off and energy kind of thing. So my mom, she's like, oh, before we walk in, don't forget to tell the house that you're there. And by telling the house that you're there, she means like you just knock on the wood or like just tap the side of the house to say, hey, we're coming in, as like a sign of respect, and you don't want to get eaten alive in there, because that's what it feels like sometimes. And I do that, and I get physical resistance. Like, it was, felt like legitimate pushback. Like, and you know how they're like, oh, ghosts have cold air. This was like warm. Like, it was warm. And I tapped the door. I'm like, okay, we're coming in. Pushback. And I was like, that's weird. That's never happened to me before. And I started assuming that was because Jesus was here, you know. Because why else would something do that, you know? Like, why do you not want me in there? Because normally I walk in, it's the same feeling, but it's not that aggressive. Like, it's never been that aggressive with me before. So I was like, damn, okay, peace out. Well, obviously I walked in. I looked around, and you know, I've been in there, they don't have anything too different, and so with this, I just walked around the house as per usual. I looked at the three people that were in the store before me and my mom, my nan were there, and I can't tell if it's something in the house, if it's the house itself, because houses are beings too, they are angry, they can be angry, they can be happy, they can be sad, everything has energy for me. And I'm looking at the lady, I'm like, damn, I can't tell if she's the problem or if the house is adding on to whatever problem she has, because it looks like there's no life behind her eyes. There's none. I've never met somebody. Everybody has life behind their eyes to some degree. I've never met somebody that's looked like they legitimately were dead while being alive. Like, that was a first for me, because I stood there and I was like, what? What? Because it was weird. Like, she looks sick. And then there was a lady that was standing next to her, and she was like way younger, because the person I'm talking about is like a grandma. She's old as fuck. Like, I'm sure, if she's not already dead, if she's an actual person sitting there, I'm very surprised. Keep in mind, I can't see ghosts. It's more like it's not that good. Not that good of a psychic, trust me. Otherwise, I'd make it my job. But if she was not already dead, I would be extremely surprised if she doesn't kick the bucket soon. I wouldn't be surprised at all. Because she looked like she was already dead. But she was a living person, because two people were talking to her. Well, actually, I'm not sure if two people were talking to her. Because now that I think about it, it was two people talking to each other, and the old lady was just sitting there watching. So, maybe she was dead. She looked pretty real to me. And I've talked to her before. And then the other two people there that were there was an older guy that was probably around the same age as a lady, maybe like a year or two younger, like 78. And then it was like a lady in her late 30s, and she was mad. I don't know what it was, but she was giving off like, rah, you know, she was like, boo, and I was like, oh, you know. And the guy, I don't know if it was because the guy was there, if he was mad about something, I was not paying that much attention, but I just watched them for a second, and I think they were mad at him or whatever and stuff like that. And so I finish walking around the house and I go back around the stairs to meet, like, I go back because you walk in and it's a staircase. It's a two-story house. You walk in, it's a staircase. To the left is the living room. Well, it's your guys' right. But like physically, if you're standing there, it's to my left. And then there's the living room, the dining room, the kitchen. And then I'm not sure what this part of the house would be called, but like another living room per se, or like it's connected to the kitchen, because it's, you have the hallway. It's all connected like some way, but I think there's a basement to the house. I'm not really sure where to find that at, because you can't access the entire thing. The staircase, you can't go up, but it leads to a second floor. And then you have like just four rooms, and then there's another part of like this room right here. It's easier if I draw it, because I'm not that good at explaining directions. I've never been good at explaining directions, so let me just draw it, and then I have something to show. Wait, let me just show you guys now. Look at this little guy. He's a pom pal. He's a little axolotl. And then I think he has a name, but I don't remember it. His name is Axe. Axe is perfectly content to just floating around all day. Oh my god, look at him! Sorry, I really love that little guy. This is what I was touching when I was talking. I was messing with his little fin thingies. Or like his little hair. Hair? Is that what it's called? Here, let me draw this. My dad's a construction worker, so I'm gonna draw this like the construction worker way. So it's like the stairs, and then there's, I'm just gonna draw a box, because that's essentially what it is. So you have the box. You have the box. You have the door, and then it's split down the middle. So you walk in and the staircase is literally right here. The staircase, and then this is like, this goes up into another room, and there's two rooms on the second floor. There's one that branches off into a hallway that goes like an L shape. There's one that branches off into a hallway that goes like an L shape, and the room's right here. And then there's one that is like right next to the stairs, I'm pretty sure. I don't know if that's certain, because like I said, I can't go up there. I've never been up there. But for the most part, the house is split up like this. And then there's another door right here that leads into the kitchen. And then she has like the shelf. And so, and then there's a wall. There's another wall, and there's another wall. But there's no doors, like, anywhere here. So, S for stairs, R1, R2, R3, R4. So, this is what the house looks like. Oh my god, you can't see it. Okay, so this is what the house looks like. This is the front door. This is where you walk in. This is a haunted house, by the way. That I've been in and I don't like. Nobody likes this house, and I'm going to go there next Sunday and investigate. I'm just showing my friends that the fact that it's haunted. So this is the front door, and this is a staircase right here. This, you immediately see the staircase. So I walked around, went through room one, which is like the living room, went to two, went to three, went to four. My mom and my nan were still in R2, so when I walked around and I just watched a couple people that were here in like R4, well, I walked around back to the front door, and I'm standing here looking up at the staircase. I shit you not. Listen, I used to be able to see ghosts, like, pretty readily, and this was the first time I'd seen a, in quotations, ghost in, I'm talking like 15 years. And I walk by the staircase. I look up the staircase. Image flashes in my mind. I'll show you what it looked like. And I was like, because keep in mind, I haven't seen shit like this in 15 years. Well, it's probably not right. It's more like 10. I haven't seen shit like this in 10 years. So I was a little shook, and I was like, okay, I'll leave. Because it's not like it was like, get out of my house. It feels like you're walking into a house uninvited, if that makes any sense. And so, let's see if I can draw it. You have the stairs, the wall, and then it's like this. And then this is a hallway. You have the banister. Someone is mowing. This is not a really good... description of the house, if that makes any sense. But wow, these are some really bad stairs. And then you have like, there's another thing right here. It's like a banister that goes all the way down. You have this. I saw You scared the shit out of me. I'm not even kidding. Thank you, Acoustic Games Z. I'm talking about a haunted house. Okay, so I don't consider myself much of a psychic. And I used to be able to see ghosts, which... yeah, no worries. Like, it's not that... I forget that my notification sound is that loud. Also, I just wasn't expecting it. But I'm currently drawing what I saw at the top of a staircase in a haunted house. And like I said, I don't consider myself much of a psychic because I haven't been able to see ghosts in like... this one, I don't think he would like to talk very often, like at all. And if he does, it's in an aggressive way. And I can't like really investigate this house per se. This is a really bad drawing. This is a really bad drawing. I can't really investigate this house per se because I'm pretty sure the owner, if she's not already dead, is getting ready to die. And I'd rather not be the last person she talks to and then she like kicks it, you know? But you know those like 18th century portraits where the dad and the mom and like maybe the two kids are standing on the staircase and they're like, the dad's like this with his cane and he has his hand on the banister? This is what I saw at the top of the staircase. And I was like, because keep in mind, I haven't seen shit in years. And I also think I might have seen another ghost. But I don't know if she's a ghost or not, because she's kind of, it's hard to explain, but have you ever met a person that feels like they're dead? Because I feel like people that aren't empaths or, like, in tune to that kind of stuff it's, like, really hard for them to grasp the concept of, I feel very entitled saying that for some reason. I don't know, I feel like I said that wrong. Or, like, in a weird or a mean way. Or, like, I'm elite because I can see things. Like, no. Nothing like that. But I just feel like it's hard for people to grasp. Oh, my goodness. Sorry, my bracelet keeps hitting my mic. Wait, I just realized you can't see. Where'd it go? My chat box was gone. Oh, my God. I don't know why I did that. Yeah. That's borderline the same with me, and, like, I haven't done that in a couple years, but I am one of those people that is able to walk into a space and be like, damn, what are the vibes in here? That's why I'm so, like, definite, and my mom is the same way, and since she's been alive way longer than I have, She can do it a lot better than I can. And so she's usually my check. Like, I'm like, damn, this place has a weird vibe. Hey, mom, does this place have a weird vibe? And she'll go, yeah. Or she'll go, it depends. You know, like, if we walk into an antique store, this is normally where the vibes are. The antique stores usually have vibes. And by vibes, I mean, like, just off-putting is what I mean. So this specific antique store, I am positive, is, like, haunted. 1,000,000,000%. And it's by something that's, like, really mean on it, like, and I'm not sure if mean's the right way to put it, per se, but I know it's mean because it gave me pushback when I walked.
Even if your team's not in the same place, your work
can be. Oh my god,
be.
Sorry,
you
I got an ad, and I was like, why is there a woman song talking in my ears?
Work, so teams know what to
I
do.
I got really confused for a second. I was like,
and
oh my god.
How get done. Try it for free
what
at Asana.com. That's
Asana?
Asana?
Girl, I don't care. Okay, back to the jazz. Anyways, this is, like, the first time this house has ever been, like, raw to me, you know? And I don't normally get that. I normally walk into a place and I'm not, like, bombarded with a, you need to leave. It's more of a, like, damn, this shit's weird. The hell happened here? And then I do my business and I leave. Like, I'm not overstaying my welcome. Yeah. Actually, though, you get it. Okay, so, dude, I completely forgot. So I'm actually going ghost hunting, like, next Saturday with my friends. I'm showing them the haunted antique store that gave me pushback because I was wearing a cross. And, you know, there's two, I asked my mom about it because I hadn't told her about it yet. And she was like, well, because I wear a rosary. Which you're not supposed to do. You're not supposed to wear rosaries, but I wear it for a different reason. Because I'm not Christian, per se. I guess you would call it agnostic. But I wear this for my God and my God alone, not the Christian God. And you're not supposed to wear these. I've recently found out that it's, like, it's not a cardinal sin, but it's definitely, you're not, like, it's not recommended.
Thank you. Really? That's no.
Oh my god, it's working. I had to try the classic plug it back in and unplug it. Okay, hold on, guys. I have no idea what the hell just happened. But I can tell that my audio is peaking for whatever reason. It's still peaking. Yada, rada. Okay. That must be a sign. That has to be a sign. I've never had that happen to me before. And I'm talking about ghost hunting. Okay. I had to double check. Anyways, what was I talking about? It was... I'm going ghost hunting this Sunday, and I'm going to go show my friends the spooky haunted house. Yeah. So, I wear this just for shits and giggles. Well, not really. But you've already heard that explanation. And so, my mom, she's like, hey, don't forget to let the house know that you're coming in, which is basically you just knock on the side, or you're like, you tap in, you're like, hey, I'm gonna come in, because sometimes houses don't like people, and that's okay. Our house, our beautiful, lovely home, fortunately loves us. And she's, like, royally protected by whatever. She's just serene, if I dare say. And my voice cracked. And I... knock on the wood. I like, hey, coming in, kind of deal. And I get like physical pushback, like, whoa, that was a lot. That's why I was like, man, this house is kind of mean, because I've never had that happen to me before. However, since you're not supposed to wear rosaries, it could have been the house being angry that I was wearing a rosary, or it could have been the house being angry that I had a cross on me. You never know. Happens to the best of us. Oh, and when I was in there, and I saw the thing at the top of the stairs, just, you know. And I had said that I didn't know if I had seen another ghost or not, is because the lady that works there is this really old woman. And when I went there the last time, I had walked around, and I saw her sitting at the desk, and there was two people that were there. It was like a woman in her early 30s, my bad, and a super old fucking man, like 86. And those two were talking, and they were pissed off. And the reason I was like, it's hard to explain what it feels like when it comes to people. If you're not already an empath or, like, some form of, like, damn, this vibe's weird, you know? Dude, that's real. See, with my house... I love my house because it's literally protected. I don't know why or how, but it is, like, awesome. And you can feel when somebody, like, when something's, like, bang, bang, to, like, whatever barrier is around the house. Because the vibes will be off. The vibes will... And I'm like, damn, the fuck going on in here? Oh, okay, let me finish the other story really quickly before I finish this one. So, I was walking around, I saw the three people that were there. It was the old lady, it was the other lady, and then it was the old ass man. And so, hold on. It's fine. Nah, I just love talking. So, like, when I start talking about something I'm passionate about, I'm like it everywhere. I talk about everything all at once, and there's no stopping me. But... I was watching them because the old lady that was there, it felt like she was dead. It felt like she was dead, but she was a living person. Like, have you ever met anybody that's been like, damn, the fuck is wrong with you? You know? And I don't mean, like, you're a weird fucking person, like, personality-wise. I mean, like, you talk to them, and it's literally like they don't have a soul. Like, there's nothing going on within them physically. Like, they feel like nothing. And everybody brings a presence. So I don't like people that feel like nothing, because they're usually, like, energy goes to them. And so, with her, it was the old man and the lady, the other lady, were talking to each other, and the old lady was sitting at the, like, kiosk thingy, like, the desk where you ring everything up. And I don't know if she was dead or alive. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if she was actually dead, and I just happened to see her and not know it. Because she looked pretty physical. Like, she looked real. And I don't know, but she just felt like she had no presence. It was really weird. And I didn't like that, because I was like, dude, this house has a weird effect on you. Like, you need to get out of here. Because it even has a physical effect on me every time I go in. Like, it is, it's suffocating to be in that house, I swear. Okay. Now that that's done, when it comes to my house, though, I've officially named her Bella, because last night, or the night before last, one of those, it was a nighttime, some time of night, someday. That made no fucking sense. Okay, sorry. I don't know how to explain it. But I was thinking, and I was watching a Sam and Colby video, as one does at 3 in the morning, and I was like, damn, do people just, like, you walk in a house, and I forgot what it was, but I was talking about houses and how people tend to not be able to discern whether it's the house. Well, me too. It's hard to discern sometimes. If it's the house or something in the house. See, for me, I'm like a happy-go-lucky person. Or at least, I used to not be. Because mental illness. Anyways, I'm very much like a happy-go-lucky person. Like, I'm... Oh, hold on. There we go. I like living in bliss. I'm one of those... I am the definition of... what is it? Shit, I fucking forgot. It's the... Like... The... It is bliss. Like... It's like, is bliss. And I forgot the beginning, but it's like... It's like, idiocy is bliss? Something like that. I forgot what the fucking phrase is. But I am that. Like, I prefer to not know. Yes, ignorance is bliss. I am that person. I am the phrase, ignorance is bliss. Because I prefer not knowing. Like, knowing makes me not, like, anxious. Like, I'll spend, like, hours crying over facts that I can't fix. Yeah, but for me, since I'm one of those, like, ignorance is bliss people, even though I'm like, damn, you're fucking weird, it's hard to do for me, because I'm so, like, I'm an in-the-moment person, and then I think back on it later, and I'm like, meh, it's not that weird, but, like, It's easy to do if you're in a situation where you're like, who the fuck are you people? But for me, when I'm in a situation where it's like, who the fuck are you people? I'm more concerned in, well, I wouldn't say concerned is the right word. I'm more into, like, talking to them and being friends with them than I am at immediately clocking them as, oh my god, you're weird! You know? Like, I can only clock places as weird really fast, but when it comes to people, I'm really bad at it. Yeah. Like, when it comes to people, nah. Not a fucking sense in the world. However, if I look back on it, I'm like, oh, yeah. I don't know how I didn't see it in the first half. You know? Oh, I never finished the story about my house. With my house, I can normally clock when something's, like, trying to enter, or, like, trying to, like, be in the house or something like that, especially if it's, like, negative, because the energy in my in the house will flip like a fucking dime. I wrote it down. I made a whole tweet about it last night because oh, hold on. My friend texted me. Let's read what he has to say. Chad says... No! Oh my god! Sorry, his work schedule changed. So he doesn't get off work early. And so I can't go to his house early. Because we're planning on spending the night at his house so we can actually get to, like, the places I'm trying to get them to at a reasonable time. But anyways, back to what I was talking about. I made a tweet last night about it. I timestamped it. I made a whole thing because it was weird. And because normally, maybe it was because I was thrown off because I got jump scared by a bug last night and I don't know where it is. So much to the fact that I'm armed with a vacuum currently. And I was like, damn, the fuck going on? Like, so much so to the point I was like, leave the vicinity. And obviously it's not like that now. Like, I don't feel like, well, you know, but hold on. I literally just saw it, but since I tilted my phone, it refreshed the page. I said, timestamp tweet so I can tell my mom about it later. LMAO with 3 O's. I said, 2:42 a.m. and the energy feels so weird for some reason. Literally no clue why. It just feels weird and ugh, you know? Maybe the world shifted or something. Told whatever might have been in my room to skedaddle. Yeah. Because I've had instances like that before, but I couldn't tell. Because, okay, so I'm not a horror person. I don't like horror. I can't watch horror. I don't watch scary movies. I don't watch anything like that. I'm also not a gore person. Can't do anything like that. However, ghost hunting videos, love them. I'll eat that shit up for days. So I was watching a Sam and Colby video last night. Well, I thought it was weird because, hold on. My chair's weird. I'm trying to put my feet on the wall so I can, like, lean back, but I have socks on and my legs are too short because I don't have my chair pulled up enough, so I guess I'm just gonna have to suffer. But I had my chair pulled all the way back because I was looking for the bug to try and vacuum it up so I could sleep peacefully. And I had my chair pulled all the way back and I start hearing it move. And I'm like, the fuck? Like, what kind of fucking Nukes Top 5 is happening right now? Because it literally... So, my chair is super creaky. Like, if I move in my chair, you can hear it. Like... Well, I can't hear it now. Of course. When I try to demonstrate, you can't hear it. I love when that happens. But... It started moving. And I was like, the fuck? Because you have to keep in mind, my shit does not move. Nothing in my room, nothing in my house moves. There's no ghosts in my house. My house is not haunted. Nothing strange. None. My house completely serene.
This is why I switched to Shopify.
Oh my god, not
Shopify
again!
Made it really easy for me to shift everything over and hit the ground running. I was easily able to migrate my products and all of my customer information over.
We're gonna mute it. And then I will unmute. So, just in case. Okay, there we go. Excuse me, my bad. But my chair started fucking moving. I was like, damn, the fuck? Because my chair doesn't move by itself. Not one of those things. Not an item that does that. I've had this chair sitting in this exact position until last night, and it's never done that before. And it moved twice, like, in the span of 2 hours. I was like, damn, and it never moved again. Yeah, it be like that sometimes. For me, because I'm a chill person, or in quotations, chill person, I wouldn't say chill, I'm just curious. Like, I am curiosity killed a cat kind of person. as well as ignorance is bliss, which doesn't make sense because you would think those two don't go together, but they do. And so with this, I was like, damn, my chair fucking moving. Well, it happens. Obviously, I wasn't like scared by it. I was like, damn, the fuck? And then I went on with my life. However, like a couple hours after that, I was like, damn, the hell going on? Because it literally flipped like a dime. I was like, whoa. And during that time, my chair didn't move. Nothing happened. It was just a really weird, like, dude, what is going on kind of feeling, you know? And so with that brings me to another story. I was watching a movie called The Power of the Dog. Don't watch it. Not worth it. Unless you're like a film critic. I was just watching it as a casual person because Benedict Cumberbatch was in it and gay people. So I was like, ooh, you know? And so, I was eating, I think I was eating raviolis. No, I was eating soup. I had made soup to watch an old ass Western movie. And I was sitting there, I had my soup, I had finished my soup, and I put my bowl like right next to my desk, which is like right here in this area. And so I am watching the movie, chilling. I think I was eating crackers at that point because, you know, what can you do? Because there's only like this much soup left. And I hear the spoon lift up the bowl and fucking drop. And I saw it move out of the corner of my eye, and I was like, oh my god, oh my god. Because I wasn't like scared, I was freaking out because I was like, how the fuck did it do that? But not in a like, oh my god, there's a demon in my house, but in a, that fucking moved by itself. And I didn't feel it. Like, there was nothing going on in my room to the point that I was like, damn, that's kind of strange. You know? Like, I didn't immediately go, ghost? In my room? No, that shit just moved. And I was like, you know, because, it's not a good way to, let's see if I, oh, here, I have a bowl. This bowl has popcorn in it, so don't mind that. Sorry, I thought I saw a bug in it and I got scared. This is just popcorn seeds in here, but it was sitting like, I don't wanna, I do have a fork, but, no, I'm not sure why that happened. I honestly don't know, because that's never happened to me before. Like, I've never had that problem, like, midstream. I've had stream, like, stop because of internet issues, but I've never had it, like, just cut like that, you know? I don't want to use my pencil because I kind of like that pencil. But I'll demonstrate nonetheless with it. Basically, the spoon was sitting in the bowl. I want to show you the inside. And it literally went, obviously not that dramatic, but it was similar to that. And I was like, I have a whole video of it and everything. Not the spoon moving, because I cut as soon as it did that. But of my reaction to it, because I thought there was like a bug, maybe there was a mouse in the bowl for some reason that I didn't know about, because it's 4 in the morning. Why is my spoon moving at 4 in the morning? You know? And oh wait, you don't even know the background, like the background story behind why my bedroom looks like this. Okay, anyways, we'll get to that. But the spoon moved. I got the reaction to me seeing the spoon moving, but I didn't get me recording the spoon moving, which was crazy because I thought there was like maybe a bug in the bowl, maybe a mouse in the bowl, little mouser in the bowl. No, nothing. The spoon moved by itself. I was like, no fucking way, you know? Okay, anyways, why my room looks like this? Fun fact, I don't live like this. My brother is moving back home. And he's going to be here Saturday, which, if you didn't know, is tomorrow. What is today, Friday? Yeah, I should know that, because I only stream 3 days a week. But, so, my mom so graciously put all of my shit in the closet from over there, because that's where my room used to be. in my room. So there you go. I'm not a hoarder. Oh my god, what time zone are you in? 2 a.m.? Okay. 7? Hold on, let me do math. 9 hours ahead. General Mountain Time? Where the fuck is that at? I think that's what that is. General Mountain Time? Oh, brother, you got that New Zealand time or some shit. I couldn't do the math in my head anyways. Oh, shit! I forgot the main point of the stream! I was so busy talking about ghosts! Okay, so... Oh my god! You do got that New Zealand time! That's Australia time, though. You got that motherfucking Australian time. I think that's where that is. Wait, that's even cooler! Wait, that's actually so cool. Anyways. Wait, that's actually so cool! What the heck? That's so far away from me. I'm from Ohio. Okay, I forgot the whole point of the stream. So, a tarot reading, obviously. And I wanted to do a tarot reading for Sam and Colby. Because I don't know if Sam and Colby have ever gotten a tarot reading before, so it might be a little difficult. But I have... I have, I have four tarot sets right here. This is my favorite one. This is my best friend, tarot set-wise. My bestie, Gummy Bear Tarot. Love Gummy Bear Tarot. She is the greatest tarot set that's ever happened to me. And she is the one and only, I swear. Then we have my other friend. We have Cat Tarot. Love Cat Tarot. Greatest thing that's ever existed, too. We have... This was gifted to me by my Nan. I bought the other two. I bought this one at a Ren Fair from a psychic. For $19, by the way. And these are, like, medieval. These are Mind, Body, and Spirit tarot set. These... My first child. My first child. I use these heavily learning how to do tarot. And then... This is an acquaintance. I don't know how to use these. This is a demon tarot set. I don't use these. And they don't like me very much. And I don't think that they don't like me. There's just some cards in here that are really hard to interpret because they're tricksters and other such forms. And yeah... So I don't use these very much, but since I was like, you know what? It's Sam and Colby. Let's see what the cards say. You know, might as well go all out for shits and giggles. And so we're going to pull a card from each. So we're going to start with the Gummy Bear Tarot, and then I'm going to pull one from here and then read about it. Gummy Bear Tarot. Okay. Oh, shoot. Here. You get to see my desk. There's ominous baby legs right here. Whoopsies. So, that's why I'm, like, decked out in all my jewelry today as well. Or no, it's not all. But it is definitely some. that's why I have my rosary as well. Specifically because it's, like... Like... I just wanted to... You know, ensure... Because for Sam and Colby, okay, we're going to TED Talk for a moment, so I might as well do this. For Sam and Colby, I have a feeling that there is something about Colby that the spirits are like, to, you know? And I feel like Sam gives him a 20-foot parameter of, like, you cannot touch him, if that makes any sense. Which was not my original conclusion. That is, like, the conclusion I came to after watching several videos. Because when... I think the very first video I watched of them was the video they did with Carl and Foolish Gamer. Also known as Noah. And I really liked that video, so I wanted to watch more, and since I ran out of Life of Luxury content to watch, oh no, one of my cards is chipped. This is so sad. Come here, little fella. What's wrong? No! Oh no! It's coming off the base. This is so sad. This is how well-loved these cards are. Okay. But for Zam and Colby, the reason I wanted to do a tarot reading for them is because when I was watching their investigation they did with Carl and Foolish, I started realizing that though there wasn't much of, it was just like a first impression type deal for Sam and Colby, that there was something about Colby that was different. Like, Colby is just different as a person, and you can tell. And so is Sam. Sam's really different. It's like a sun and moon kind of scenario in my head for them, which isn't the exact interpretation, but it's the most widely known universal interpretation of what I would describe them as. And so with that, I continue watching more of the videos. I think the second video I watched of Sam and Colby was there, we stayed the night at the Conjuring House. Now, the Conjuring House, I can tell you, is relatively haunted. But I wouldn't go as far to say that there are, like, demons in it. Even though with Amanda there, Amanda the Psychic, they brought her on, and I wish they brought her on more. I fucking love Amanda the Psychic. Amanda the Psychic, I love you. Just putting that out there. Her energy is so clean, and she is so nice. Like, there is just something about her. I don't know if she's said this before, but I feel like she has, considering I use it now too. But I think she's like a lighthouse. Or she's like... yeah, that's what I'm saying. And then with Amanda, she's like a lighthouse. Last night, I was doing like a reaction, like filming before I got interrupted by a bug. And of them at the Shanley, not fucking haunted, by the way. And if it is haunted, it's very occasional. Like, you have to be there for a long time for anything to happen to you. But with the Conjuring, hold on, I got sidetracked. With Amanda, I feel like she's, you know how you put, sometimes you see lights and like moths are like hitting the lights repeatedly? That's what I feel like she's like. Except she's like the bug zapper light, where like the moth hits it and it goes and he fucking dies. That's what I feel like she is for like evil people or like evil anything. Or, like, negative anything is how I should put it. Evil's a bit of an overstatement. But with Sam and Colby, I think it was... since it was the second video that I watched, just, like, interpretation-wise, I just assumed that Colby already knew that he was a psychic to some degree. Like, I just assumed Colby already knew he had some, like, form of psychic ability because of the way he does Estes. And also what was coming through with the Estes. Because with... I feel like it's a conversation. Whenever they do Estes, it's a conversation between two people. Especially at the Conjuring. It was definitely a conversation between two people. And I just had assumed Colby already knew that he had psychic abilities to some degree. I don't know how much of a psychic ability he considers himself. Oh my goodness gracious, I'm talking too much. Even though it's my job, I'm like, you know? I just assumed Colby knew that he was, like, part psychic to some degree. And the reason I came to the conclusion that Sam gives him, like, a 10-foot pole, like a 10-foot pole when it comes to like ghosts. Yeah, I have to, but I've just been like, damn, I'm talking so much. Because when I start, like, stuttering over my words, that's when I know I've reached my max, like, words per minute capacity, you know? That and my throat starts hurting. Because I don't talk a lot. Believe it or not, I am not a talking person when I'm at my house. Like, even when I'm outside, I rarely, if ever, talk this long. Okay, Sam and Colby, what was I saying? Oh, the reason I came to the conclusion that Sam gave him, like, a 10-foot pole when it came to spirits or ghosts or whatever it is just because of the way he is. Like, I also just assumed that Colby was one of those people that had a lot of ghosts interactions with him when he was younger. Like, maybe he lived in a haunted house, maybe he, was like, maybe he saw stuff when he was younger, maybe he was like picking up on stuff that was weird, and he was like, man, this is really weird, like, we should get out of here kind of deal. And then I just assumed that he already knew that he was like that, but apparently he didn't, based on later videos that I saw. And so I never came to that conclusion because of who Sam is and because of how Sam is. Because you can listen, as a content creator, you can always, almost always, 100% tell when people That's cool. Me too, honestly. Once again, I live in Ohio. Like, I ain't floating anywhere. Like, I ain't doing anything when it comes to, like, demons, you know? That's why I kind of want to start my own ghost hunting company. And when with watching Sam and Colby, I've gotten the courage to, like, do that. Because if they can do it, then so can I, kind of mentality, you know? And since I'm already a content creator in general, I'm like... Anyways, back to what I was going to say. The reason I say that about Sam is that he's like a light pole, a lighthouse as well, and is very much like a get back, foul beast to ghosts, is because of who he is. And when it comes to creating content, for me at least, I don't know if anybody else is like that, like this, but you can 100%, or like, I wouldn't say 100%, but like 98% be able to tell when a content creator is not as much as themselves on camera as they are off camera. Or like, you can tell, for me at least, just because I'm one of those people, you can tell when people aren't who they say they are on camera and who they say they are off camera, if that makes any sense. Because there's only so much, like, there is only so much you can say and do before the cap of who you are off camera interacts and is shown on a camera, you know? And when it comes to Sam, also just because of his eyes are always telling. And when it comes to Sam, I'm like, yeah, he seems pretty genuine. Obviously, he's not going to show everything ever on camera. But when it comes to him, it's like, yeah, I would say he's a pretty genuine person when it comes to being on camera. Same with Colby. I would say Colby's pretty genuine, but he's a secretive kind of person in general, you know? Like, golden retriever, black cat kind of deal, if that makes any sense. But I could be completely wrong, you know? Like, I'm not always 100% right, so don't take my word for it. This is just what I assumed and what I came to the conclusion for. And because of how Sam is and who I assume him to be because of what I've seen on camera, I just assumed that he was like, be gone, demons! Like, whacking him with a cross. When it came to Colby and the locations that they're at. Because I also came to the conclusion that there was something attached to Colby in a couple of the videos that I watched, but apparently he got like rid of it or something. But I, because I asked one of my seasoned Sam and Colby enjoyers, that is a very strange way to put that. I'm so sorry, Silver, if you ever see this. I recommend it. Sam and Colby are pretty good. Or at least I like their content quite a bit, because they're mainly just like haunted stuff, you know. That's interesting. I've never done or tried astral projection, specifically because I'm too scared to. But with Sam and Colby, that was a segue. But I asked one of my friends, this is the better way to put it. I asked one of my friends, who is a much more seasoned Sam and Colby fan, and enjoyer, that, like, does Colby have anything attached to him? Like, I just get the weird feeling that there's something with him. And he was like, yeah, there is, but they got rid of it. And I was like, are you sure? He was like, yeah, I'm positive. And I was like, are we sure? Because it hasn't really shown up, so maybe they did. But when it comes to Colby doing Estes, it's like, Colby, who are you talking to? Because I don't think it's a ghost in the room. I think that's you. I think that's something you have. Because, like I said, there is something about Colby. And with Sam, I don't get it. I don't get it. With Sam, I don't get the same feeling as I get looking at, like, this is a really weird way to put this. I'm so sorry, because I'm going to be making, like, clips of this. With Sam, I do not get the same impression or feeling that I do when I look at Colby. With Colby, it's like the color purple, if that makes any sense. Sorry, my monitor turned off. It does that sometimes. Like, oh my god, my voice cracked. With Colby, it's like looking at the color purple. If that makes any sense to anybody, it's like looking at the color purple. Like, I look at him and I'm like, you are an interesting fella, aren't you? And I look at Sam, and it's like looking at the color blue. If that makes any sense. I bet it doesn't. Because no one's like a color theory person like I am. Even though it's not color theory, it's just color interpretation. Aw, the sunset. I kind of wanted to go on a drive, but it's fine. And by drive, I'm learning how to drive. With Colby, like I said, I just get a different impression than I do with Sam. Like, if anyone were to have a demon or negative entity, yeah, I would say like that. That's actually a way better way of putting it. But with Sam, with Cold, okay, what am I trying to say? If anyone ever were to have anything attached to them that is like negative, or like something that's negative but likes Colby specifically but doesn't like anybody else, I wouldn't be surprised, because he's just one of those people. Like, I will not be surprised at all if Colby ever talks about him having like paranormal experiences growing up, or like seeing objects move on their own, or like hearing things move but nothing actually moved, you know. Or being like, oh, I saw shadow people when I was younger, stuff like that. Like, I would not be surprised. With Sam, I would be a little surprised if he's had, that's not the best way to put it. I wouldn't be surprised, but I would also be surprised depending on the severity of what he says. Because with Colby's experienced things that are more negative. With Sam, it's like more positive spirits or energies, if that makes any sense. I feel like I'm doing a fucking dissertation, like, right now, about Sam and Colby and their ghosts. Because I don't know. It's literally just them. if that makes any sense. Like, I've watched other ghost hunters. I fucking watched Zach Bagans. I put up with Zach Bagans for 10 years of my life, okay? Like, that makes no sense, because I don't know Zach Bagans personally. I just watch his show. I put up with Zach Bagans for 10 years of my life, show-wise. Like, I can tell you right now who is what and why, you know? Zach, I'd punch him. Zach, I'm onto you. I'm in your walls. Like, with Zach? No, I don't like him. I don't think he's a good person. Sorry, Zach Bagans. I don't view you as a kind soul. I view you as a narcissist. Honestly, I do. Maybe not in the beginning, but certainly now. Even in the beginning. I lied. Even in the beginning. I would be like, yeah, you're fucking weird. With everybody else on the team, relatively okay. Yeah. Yeah, exactly like that. That's why I'm like, that's why I'm so adamant that Sam and Colby are so different for some reason. I'm not sure why. And I'm literally not sure why they're so different than anybody else that I've watched. Because I watch Life of Luxury, okay? I love Life of Luxury. It's a good horror channel. Even though I'm not a fan of horror, once again, I don't watch their content alone because I'm scared of horror. But with them, I can read them like a fucking book. Sam and Colby, I can read them like a book that has two chapters. Like, but the book only has two chapters, if that makes sense. Like, Life of Luxury, entire book, both of them. Sam and Colby, a book and a half. A book even, at least. Like, they're not secretive people energetically, so it's like, you know, like, I'm looking into your soul, you know, like, I am looking at you. I kind of deal with them, you know, but they're just different. They're different. If, like, yeah, that's why I'm so, like, adamant that Colby's a psychic. Sam is a lighthouse. Sam is a lighthouse. Colby is a psychic. I am 100% certain. I also wouldn't be surprised, because he's done it in videos. He's done it in videos. And I'm so, like, yeah. Because Colby's done it in videos where he's like, he walks into a room, he's like, damn, this shit's fucking weird. And I'm like, hey, I do that. That's why I was like, oh, he's a psychic. That's why I just assumed he knew he had those abilities. But apparently he didn't know he had those abilities and was very surprised to find out that he was a Life Path 11. I just assumed that he knew. So, yeah. In, with Sam, I, lighthouse, light pole, whatever you want to call it, a life path 11. So a life path number is basically like sacred geometry or whatever. It's just like number shit that you do. And so how you find out your life path number is basically you take your birthday and you add all of the numbers together. Here, let me move this out of the way and I'll show you. And that's how you find out. Because it's 1 to 9 are the life path numbers, and you have outliers such as 11, 22, and 33. So, sorry, I have a book right here that I'm going to use because I already have my numbers in it. So, my birthday is July 28th, 2004. That's when I was born. You can figure out where I live. No, I'm joking. So, what you would do is... Oh, shit. My government name was in there. I can't have you see that. Sorry, I'm scribbling it out. Let's do it this way. So I have like a... There you go. It should be a pretty sharp point. Yep. So this is what you would do. See, I've added it, and that's my government name that I've blacked out. And then you add your numbers. My bad. So basically, I am supposedly Life Path 5, but I felt like Life Path 5 didn't fit me, so I redid it with my name, and I was like, okay, that makes more sense, because my Life Path was 3. I think... I'm not sure. It's one of those. So, you would add 7... because it's the month, like the numeral of the month you were born. So I was born in July, so it'd be 7. And then plus 2, plus 8, because I was born the 28th. And then it'd be plus 2, plus 0, plus 0, plus 4, because I was born in 2004. I'm 18. And so you would add all of those numbers. You'd go 7, well, you just, yeah. 0, 0 is 0. Be 2 plus 0 plus 4 plus 8 plus 2 plus 7, 7, 8, 9, 9 plus 8 plus 2 plus 4, 4, 5, 6, 6 plus 8 plus 9, and then, oh my goodness gracious, golly gosh, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, wait, 9, oh my god, guys, I promise you I graduated. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 17. So, and then 17, if you get a double digit number, no. So, if you have, those are the outliers. So, if you have something that, like, if you get 11, 33, or 22, those are the outliers, and you don't reduce those down, from my understanding. However, if you get anything that's above those numbers, like, by the time you add everything together, you have to re-add. So, 9 plus 8, I need a fucking calculator, I can't do this shit in my head. If you get past 7, yeah. Hold on, I'm pulling out a fucking calculator. 9 plus 8 is 17, so I would then do 17 plus 6. So plus 6 is 23, and then I would add the 2 plus, and then I would add 2 and 3, so it's 5. So that would be my life path number, but because I didn't like that life path number... I redid it again with my government name, and I got, what is it, 7? You can figure out how to spell my name with those numbers, so I'm not going to say them out loud. Sorry, I'm doing it in my head. So my life path number with my government name is 7. So I don't know why there's a 12 here. And I think it was because, the reason I did it with my government name is because I didn't like the life path number 5. Because it didn't fit me. And, like, your life path number is supposed to fit you. This type of deal. And I didn't like it. So I redid it with my government name. So I guess I should probably just add them together. 7 plus 5. 7 plus 5 is 12. So it reduced down to... Oh, now I know why the 12's there. Man, I went away from 11. I wanted to be a psychic. So my life path number, because I'm stubborn, would be 3. Yeah. And 3 life path wise suits me way more than anything else, because 3 is supposed to be like caring, loving, nurturing, like Mother Nature. Mother Nature is not the right way to put it, but you get the deal kind of vibe. And I'm like, yep, that's what I want. So that's what I chose. Because I didn't like life path 5, and I looked up life path 7, and I didn't like life path 7. And then you would be, if you wanted to add those two numbers together, you would be life path 11. So, which is psychic, like kind of like psychic ability. Like you are the, you know, cause 7 plus 4 is 11, right? I think. Cause I got 12 cause mine's 7 plus 3. Wait, no, 7 plus 5. Is 12. And so what was I talking about? Sam Colby? I just assumed they knew. I just assumed Colby knew he was a psychic, and I just assumed Sam knew that he was a spiritual lighthouse. Okay, time to do their tarot reading. Because that took me forever. Okay, so we're gonna start out with a gummy bear tarot set. I just got really tired. It happens to the best of us. Okay. So. Gonna. You know? Okay. I'm gonna push this back so you guys can see. And then that's why I'm wearing my crystals today as well, because of the reading I was doing. Which I don't normally wear them. Hold on. I had to tighten the ribbon. Oh my goodness, golly gosh. I need to get a better mask. Because this one makes me break out. Because of the fucking... It gets really warm in my room. And I start sweating. Okay, so. We're gonna do a Sam and Colby reading. Should I do a reading for Sam and Colby separately, or should I do one for them together? Oh, it's because I don't like, I consider myself a faceless content creator, if that makes any sense. Like, I want to create content and I want to be out there, but I don't want people to know what I look like, you know? Ooh, I will do, will do. Let's do... Okay, since I'm planning on doing a video for them, I'm gonna press record, hope for the best. Or planning on posting this tarot reading, I've already hit record. I am going to do like a little intro. It's like, what should my intro be? Sam and Colby. That's so straightforward. I'm so sorry. I do tarot readings. So. Oh my god, I don't know what to say. Okay. What should I say? What should I say? I don't know. Sam and Colby, this tarot reading is for you. I'm going to do both of yours separately, and then I'm going to do one for you two as a group. So, yeah, if I ever get to editing this. Let's hope so. Just a little backstory. I am a tarot reader. I've been doing tarot readings for a little over 5 years. So even though I've been doing them for 5 years, please forgive me for not remembering all of the cards. I have a very bad memory. But don't discredit me yet, okay? My tarot readings have come true in the past. I'm telling you. So let's get this party on the road. I guess I will do... Let's do Sam's first. Sam, this tarot reading is for you. Let's get going. Then I'll push this back so I have the whole table. Okay. I'm gonna shuffle first, and then I'm going to... There's a hair on the mic. I'm gonna shuffle first, and then I'll do the... And then I'll do... I think I'll do... Let's do... since this is my Awesomest Bestest deck, I think I will do just this one for now, and then if I, for, like, shits and giggles, want to see what this one has to say, like, a one-card pull, I might, just because, you know, it is Sam and Colby. Let's see. Okay. Do you have anything for Sam? I forget Sam's last name. Okay. Oopsies. I'm not gonna take that one since it- Actually, should I? We'll see. We'll see if this one ties in. And then I'll pull this one as the last one. What is at the bottom of the deck? Okay. Also, how I do tarot readings is I will pull 7 cards and then I will interpret those cards. I do not know if these cards are for the past, if these cards are for the present, or if these cards are for the future. I am just pulling to pull and we'll see what happens. Sometimes I'll keep the card at the bottom of the deck. So, like, this one, it's the King of Cups reverse. But since I've already pulled 7, we're going to interpret these. This does not look good. Sam, fair warning. Please don't... Sam and Colby, Sam... How do I put this? Sam, don't... want to fight me, okay? I'm just the messenger. Please don't shoot me. Sam and Colby fans, don't kill me either, okay? I'm just reading the cards. This is not my interpretation. This is what the cards are saying, not me. Because my camera's reversed, or is reversed, it looks like you guys are seeing them like right side up when they're not. So we have the 10 of Cups reversed, we have the 9 of Wands reversed, 4 of Cups reversed, the World upright, 7 Pentacles upright, 6 of Pentacles upright, and the 5 of Wands reversed. So how do I put this? Did he, I don't know if I want to say this. Did he break up with his girlfriend? Or is there like a problem with his girlfriend? Like, did they get in a fight or something recently? Or is there a problem with a group dynamic? I wouldn't say group dynamic, but it might be. There's a problem with somebody somewhere. Or there's just a problem in general. Because you have the 10 of Cups, which upright is about love, harmony, relationships, being together, like, just, it's a harmony card. Like, this is a good, like, you're coming together, everything's good, everything's great kind of deal. But it's in reverse, meaning disharmony, you're not coming together, you're upset, you're dysregulated, or deregulated. You're not regulated, if that means, like, anything. This also could mean, like, problems in relationships, stuff like that. And it's in reverse, so. And then you have the Nine of Wands, which is about being defensive, like, putting walls up, not wanting to be around people, not getting along with people, stuff like that. Let me make sure that I have that right, because sometimes I remember the wrong interpretations of the cards. So I'm just gonna double check and make sure I have the correct interpretation. So I'm also going to read the meaning of the card because it might make sense as well. Ten of Cups, conflict between self-promotion and the interests of the group, between ideals and passion, a discrepancy between what is possible and that which is real. I'm not usually this way, I just don't have time to do any better. Which makes sense. You have the Ten of Swords, which is like, damn, fuck everybody, you know, or like everybody hates you kind of moment, and then you're defensive about it because damn, like, you know. What is this? Nine of Wands. Let me make sure I have the right interpretation. I didn't have the right interpretation in the first half, but we got there in the end. Shoot, Wands is before Cups. My bad. What is this? Nine of Wands? Yeah, defensive, fear of getting hurt, not letting anyone close, repressing your fears, not confronting them. Resistance strengthens that which needs resisting to grow through obstacles. He hit a roadblock. Or like, that's why I was asking if there was a problem with somebody, or if there is like a problem in general, because this is, like I said, disharmony, stuff like that, like not getting along with the group. Nine of Wands is being defensive about it, not letting anybody in, putting up barriers. And then you have the Four of Cups, which I don't remember. Four of Cups is reversed. Mistrust, overly cautious, fear of closeness, futile search for security, envy, lack of commitment, resignation, even failure is statistically relevant. Learning to trust. What the hell happened? What the hell happened? So I have to, I'm gonna put a disclaimer really quickly. So just a small disclaimer. These cards do have a problem with me in reading for other people. Sometimes these cards are very well read when it comes to other people and they enjoy reading for other people. However, they also like to read for me. So this could apply to me, this could apply to you, this could apply to nobody. Please take with a disclaimer, please take what I say with a grain of salt. These are the cards, I'm just reading what the cards say. Okay, back to what I'm doing. Yeah, relationship problems. I'm interpreting this as relationship problems, just like as an overall, whether it be with a group, whether it be with people, whether it be with his girlfriend, whether it be with whoever. And then he's defensive about it. He's putting up walls. He's not letting anybody in. He doesn't like anybody. Like, don't get close to me type of deal. And then you have the Four of Cups, which is, you're continuing to not let anybody in. You don't want to trust. You've lost it, essentially. Like, you hate people. You never want to interact with people again, kind of deal. Like, this is what that says. And then you have, suddenly, the greatest fortune of all time, in quotations. Don't worry, I said that wrong. You have the world upright, seven pentacles of upright, six of pentacles upright, and then suddenly there's a shift here with the five of wands reversed. With the world upright, it's the ball is in your court, everything is going well, a spark has been lit, the fire's been lit, it's, things are working, things are going well. Do I know what happened in between here? No. Will I know? I don't know. Not unless I pull other cards. But what a fucking change. What a change. You have, like, all of this sadness leading up to the world. The seven of pentacles. The six of pentacles. And then you have a change in the five of wands. So, let's see. Let's double check on the world. The world is pretty straightforward. It's not that hard. So, High Priestess, Empress, Emperor, Hierophant, the Lover, Chariot, Strength, the Hermit, Wheel of Fortune, Justice, Hang, Bear, Death, Temptress, Deal, Tower, Star, Moon, Sun, Judgment, the World. Yeah. The serenity that comes from experiencing everything, joy, recognition, a sense of well-being, harmony between body and spirit, reaching greater maturity, the ability to recognize your own joy, to be thankful and enjoy life, happiness is a content heart. What happened? What happened? Why was he so, why are you so sad? And then you just, I'm fine, moment. Like, what serenity happened here? And then on top of that, you have the Seven of Pentacles, which I have to look up because I don't remember. Seven of Pentacles upright. Humor, generosity, good fortune, strongly motivated, good leader, feels joy during any task, engages himself out of the wish to give, enjoys life, trusts in the passing of time, smile and the world smiles with you. What? What the hell happened here? And then you have the Six of Pentacles. Upright, the ability to give and take in equal measure, partaking in joy, willing to learn, to accept change, the certainty that you're being led by a higher power. What you give to others, you give to yourself. What happened? Why did it change? He went from depression to the world is fine. I don't get it. And then you have the Five of Wands reversed. Five of Wands reverse. Subconscious competition with friends or partners, arguments, explosive situations through repressed conflicts, cynicism, hurtful remarks, lacks insight. My opinion is set, don't confuse me with actual facts. Task to address conflict openly. Dude. Oh, are you putting on a facade? Is there... I don't get it, because for the switch to be happening that fast, especially within cards, normally I don't get transition cards, but even then, I've never seen a flip happen so fast. Is this like a... Sam, what is going on? What is this? Depression, no depression, fights everybody. Oh, I know how to interpret this. So, I don't think it's a facade. I think it's, how I'm seeing this is, was there something that he thought was fixed that wasn't? Or did he think he had fixed something when in reality he didn't? And I don't mean that in like a, oh, he fucked up, he's gonna fix it type way. I mean that in a, something happened with somebody else, it caused him to spiral. And he thought, like, whatever happened in between here, that he had fixed it within himself, that the situation was fine, it didn't have control over him anymore, and that he was, he wasn't repressing anything. He just thought, or convinced himself, that he had fixed it with this here. But then, did somebody say something? I feel like somebody said something, and it fucking tilted him, like, off. Like, it made him pissed off. Like, I feel like this is a somebody said something. Maybe it was a passing comment. Maybe it was, like, an argument that just got under his skin. Like, something got under his skin, and that's why we had this. That, and I think he repressed it so far and convinced himself. I think he convinced himself that he was fine when he wasn't, and that's why we have this whole, like, ah, you moment, you know? I'm gonna pull more cards. Okay. Not the whole deck, please. Oh. Oh, man. Oh, man! Okay, sorry. Okay, I don't think there's anything else. I don't remember in which order these two fell out in. So, I'm gonna hope that these are how they fell out. Actually, I think it was this way, because this one was sitting at the top. This would have been the last one I pulled. Hmm. Oh my. That makes sense. So, you have the Fool reversed, the Four of Swords reversed, Nine of Cups upright, Eight of Pentacles upright, and Five of Swords upright. So, let me just get the book. So, I don't... Okay, so... the Fool upright... is about being carefree. Ignorance is bliss. Like, naivety, stuff like that. But reverse, it's obviously... ignorance is not bliss in this case. He's not ignorant. The book says... impulsiveness, rashness, naivety... oh, I lied. It's the other way around. Fear of responsibility, waste time and energy. When duty calls, let it call. Task to be free. What has you chained? Who did what to him? Is what I'm asking. Who did what to him? Sorry. I'm thinking of an image in my head. And then we have the Four of Swords reversed. I love the swords. Emotional cards. Four of Swords reversed. Afraid to reveal weaknesses. Joylessness, retreating because of arrogance, a secret wish to be a special. Wait, what? A secret wish to be special, lecturing others, hypocrisy, denying what he needs to devote himself. If you always stay quietly in your room, you'll never suffer. To discover in peace. What happened? Who did what to you? Why are you being tormented? Who is tormenting you? Black baseball cap. That's the image I'm seeing. Now what that means? I have no fucking idea. I don't know. I just keep seeing like a baseball cap, if that makes any sense. Like, it's flashing between like black and red, and I can't decide. But it's primarily black, if that makes any sense. 9 of cups upright. Let's see what it has to say. Oopsies, I'm going the wrong way. 9 of cups upright. Attractive to others, trust in oneself, aware uniqueness, readiness to show off, inspiring the best. Happiness doubles if you share it. What the fuck happened? What happened? What happened in between? What is this? It's literally like a constant battle. Like, going back and forth, like, butting heads with somebody. It's like, you butt heads with somebody. It's like having RSD, if that makes sense. RSD stands for, rejection sensitive dysphoria. This is what this reminds me of. Like, you butt heads with somebody, and you're like, damn, I'm gonna kill myself. Kind of deal. Obviously, not that intense, but it's like, damn, you butt heads, and you're like, ugh, this person obviously hates me and never wants to hang out with me again. And then you fix it, and you're fine. And then somebody says something or does something, or, like, you butt heads with somebody else, and it brings you back to that, like, it gives you RSD, and you're like, oh my gosh, this person fucking hates me. And then you go back to the cycle of thinking this person hates you, and then you clear it up. You don't think this person hates you anymore because there's no reason for them to hate you. And you go back to being fine. Like, this is RSD, if that makes any sense. And then you have the 8 of Pentacles upright. 8 of Pentacles upright. Joyful, independence, pride, skillful, creative, a good first impression. Quickly recovering from failures, willingness to admit mistakes. Throw stones in my path and I'll build stairs from them. What the hell happened? Then we have the 5 of Swords. Upright. Oh shoot. What am I doing? My brain short-circuited. 5 of Swords upright. Readiness for conflict. The courage to learn from your mistakes. Understanding that winning and losing are relative. Balance between activity and relaxation. If you don't fight, you've already lost. What does this mean? That's a bad thing to say as a tarot reader. Obviously, I know what this fucking means. But I mean, like, in retrospect, this makes no sense. Because I'm not sure how to interpret this. 10 of Cups. A relationship, a situation, something with a group. Okay, I'm activating my psychic powers. And I'm going to tell you what I think this means. Something with a group is what I'm getting. Something happened within a group dynamic changed, someone was doing something, he was doing something was up. But I'm assuming it was with somebody else, which is not the greatest assumption to make, but I'm using this as a group card. Something happened with a group. It fell apart. It dissolved. It ended really badly. And then you have him being defensive about it. Maybe he felt he was the one that caused it. Then you have the 4 of Cups, which is being even more defensive about it. Like, you've lost trust in people. You can't trust anyone anymore. And then suddenly, out of nowhere, it resolves. So, maybe this, with the drastic split between the World and the 4 of Cups here, I'm going to assume that this is, like, either, especially with the 5 of Wands here, like, either he convinced himself he was fine, or he, something happened in between. Either he convinced himself, he repressed it hard enough to where he convinced himself. I'm going to go with he convinced himself because of how hard this split is. You don't just go from, oh my god, I hate the world, I can't trust anybody, to I love the world, everything is good for me, type of deal. So I'm going to assume that he did something in between here. He convinced himself he was fine. And for a while, he was. And he thought he was. Until somebody said something. Somebody did something. I have a feeling it was a passing comment. Like, I don't know why I thought of this. But, like, you go to a function. Like, you go to a function. And there's a lot of people there. And you're talking to people. And then somebody, it's like such a brief encounter. Like, you meet them, you talk to them for a couple minutes, they say something, and they're like, okay, well, I gotta go now, bye. And you're like, why the fuck would you say that? Why would you say that? Kind of deal with the Five of Wands here. And then you have the reaction to that. You have the, like, the defensiveness, the fear, the naivety, not willing to realize or, like, fix something, or like getting in your head is how I would think about this. Like, you're like, you get in your head about it. And then you have the Nine of Cups, which is you've essentially, like, here it's back to normal. So, yeah, this is either he has RSD, or there was something that affected him. Obviously, we don't know everything about this guy, so I have no idea what any of this means. Personally, I have no fucking clue. But that's how I read this, is that a situation happened, it really got to him. He thought he was fine about it. Well, turns out he wasn't fine about it. And then he got in his head about it again, and then he got out of it. Is how I interpret this. So, Sam. So Sam, if you ever see this, which I highly doubt you will, that is my tarot reading for you. What that means, I have no idea. That's for you to decide. All I can do is tell you what the cards are saying. And what you do with that information is what you do with information. So, I'm gonna hit pause, and then we're gonna press record again. Okay. Colby, this tarot reading is for you. We're gonna see what the cards have to say, so don't shoot the messenger, everybody. And please remember that, these are just what the cards are saying. Not what I think, not what anybody else thinks, just what the cards are saying. Don't shoot the messenger, please. Colby, this one is for you. I'm gonna shuffle. I'm gonna do everything. Oh, okay. Oh my god, really? Sorry. I know as a tarot reader, it's not bad to have initial reactions to cards. But, I can't tell if this one's for me or if this one's for Colby. Because this one fell out twice for both Sam and Colby when I did their readings. But this could also just be for me. But you have the Ace of Pentacles reverse, Four of Pentacles upright, and the Empress reverse. And the card I was laughing at was the Empress reverse. Because you'll see why. If any of these cards fall out again, I'll know that they're for Colby and not for me. Sorry, my shoulder itches. Okay. I'm just going to reshuffle again. And then I'm going to do my thing. Oh, okay. Okay. Let's see what these cards have to say first. We have Two of Pentacles. What decision are you not making? And then this one followed first. Ace of Swords reversed. Oh boy. Who hurt you? This is the Lovers reverse. And then we have the Hierophant reversed. These are four cards. Is he like... Has he had like a... Like what? What is this? Oh, dude, he needs to make a decision. Colby, you need to make a decision, like, now. But, well, hold on. Let me see what the... Oh? Okay, damn, oh my god. Okay, you guys don't know why I'm so shocked by this, but the hangman upright was at the bottom of the deck every single time I stopped shuffling. So I'm gonna assume that is Colby's card. So we're gonna go this order. Actually, no, I lied. Let's do this order. Oh, wow. Okay, so that card was for him. I'm not going to be surprised. Do I have Discord open? I do. Let me mute it. I am not going to be surprised if I get the card I'm thinking. Emperor upright. Eight of Wands reversed. Oh. The Devil upright. Judgment reversed. And at the bottom of the deck, Hangman upright. Wow. Colby, the world has a lot to say to you. The spirit world has a lot to say to you, Colby. Make a decision. You have a decision to make. Okay, I think I'm gonna pull one more card. I don't remember how many I pulled for Sam. So I am going to pull, I think, two more, actually. Oh, it pulled for me. No. Okay. That's kind of crazy. So that really was his card. Wow. Okay, so at the bottom of the deck, I pulled way more than I anticipated, but we're just going to see what they have to say. At the bottom of the deck, both times, like I said, I pull from the bottom of the deck. Like, when I'm finished pulling, I'll turn the deck over and read what the card is. Both times I stopped shuffling, these two were at the bottom of the deck every single time. And I only stopped shuffling twice, so that's pretty impressive, I'm not gonna lie. But we have, wow, okay, that's really insane. Sorry, I'm just really impressed by the cards. We have Two of Pentacles reversed, Ace of Swords reversed, the Lovers reversed, the Hierophant reversed, the World upright, the Emperor upright, Eight of Wands reversed, the Devil upright, Judgment reversed, the Hangman upright, Page of Pentacles upright, Eight of Swords reversed, and Five of Pentacles upright. First off, what decision are you holding out on? What decision are you holding out on? What are you not making a choice on? Sorry, I'm thinking. what I'm, it's all mixed and jumble mumbled in my head. Okay, I have no idea who's trying to say what, but I can't understand a fucking lick. I cannot understand a goddamn lick. I feel like I'm hearing fucking backwards Latin. That's a joke. Just a hyperbole, I think is what it's called. Where's the book? Okay. Two of Pentacles upright is about, Two of Pentacles in general is just about making choices. Doesn't matter which way it's turned. Two of Pentacles upright is about making a decision. Two of Pentacles reverse is about decision making as well. Let's double check. Make sure I'm right. Two of Pentacles. Oh me, oh my. Two of Pentacles. Indifference, instability, carelessness, unable to commit. You have to take everything you need from your environment because you return empty-handed from your travels, letting go of ballast. I see this as weighing options as well. Like, if you do not have a decision to make, what options are you weighing? That's really crazy. One of the words I did hear in my head was options. But I didn't want to interpret it that way because I thought it was weird considering the cards after it. But that's interesting. I keep feeling like he's holding out on a decision. Like, he doesn't know what to decide. Or he's just, like, not deciding. Like, he's letting fate take its course kind of deal. Next up, we have Ace of Swords reversed. Ace of Swords. What am I doing? Okay, Ace of Swords reversed. Using only the head and never the heart, delving into analysis out of fear of getting emotionally involved, using wit as a weapon, problems are explained away, take it easy, life is just a bowl of cherries, tasked to be truthful. Is that why you're not making this choice? Is that why you're... Stop being so analytical. Like, get your head in the game. Get your head out of the game. Put your heart in the game, is what I mean to say. Because it is, you are looking too far into things. Like, legitimately looking too far into things. Like, let your heart decide. Let your heart go on. Celine Dion, don't pull a Titanic. Pull a Titanic song and let your heart go on. Then you have the Lovers reversed. Damn, brother, who did what to you? Inconsistency, inner conflict, expecting your partner to solve your problems, projecting your faults onto others. I married you so I didn't have to live my own life. To love oneself and to let the love shine through. Aw, he's depressed. That makes sense. Does he not have good luck with relationships? Like, is he bad at relationships? Is he, like, I wouldn't say hopeless romantic, but I wouldn't say he's good at being romantic either. Next up is the Hierophant reversed. I feel my tummy hurts. I feel nauseous. Hierophant reversed. Arrogance, abusive power. Oh my. Arrogance, abusive power, self-righteousness, feigned innocence, fear of disgrace, sensitive to criticism, opinionated. I'm the leading edge. If I am behind the curve, then that's where the edge is leading. Tasked to develop modesty and humility. Who? I mean, that makes sense. That's why I felt he was a little different than Sam. Sam is different. Colby, also different. Sorry, I sounded like South Park for a second. You have the world upright, which is everything's in your hands, essentially. This one is what I'm interested in. Wow. That's really cool. That's really cool. I should have fucking kept those cards. I should have pre-gamed those cards. Okay, so you have the Emperor upright. Let me read. You have the Emperor upright. Leadership, self-discipline, natural authority, willpower, reason, persistence. When your heart is free, no force can bind you. And then you have the Eight of Wands reversed. Hold on, I gotta go to the Eight of Wands. Ambition, good intentions lead to nothing. Activism, the need to excel. Fear of embarrassment, inner uncertainty. Able to do everything, yet unable to get anything done. Task to concentrate on one goal. That makes so much sense! That makes so much sense. That makes so much sense. Okay, so the reason I'm like, oh my gosh, that makes so much sense, is because this is falling back into old habits. This card means falling back into old habits. And like, does he vape? Like, is he a vapor? I don't know anything about Colby. But I wouldn't be surprised if he, like, smokes. Or vapes. Or does some form of the ganja. The good kush, if anybody knows what I'm referencing when I say that. Hey, Dad, look, it's the good kush. This is the dollar store. How good can it be? I fucking love that one. But he's falling back into old habits. Oh, you need to listen to someone. Someone is telling you something and you're not listening. I don't know what it is, but that one's pretty prevalent. You need to listen to someone. I don't know who, but you need to listen to someone telling you something. 'Cause I just got, like, literally shouted at the words, listen, like big font, everything, letters, size 12 New Roman. That's a little bigger, like size 30 New Roman, okay? Like bold and everything. And then you have the hang, wait, hold on, my bad. I didn't even read the Judgment card. Next card is Judgment reversed. Oh my. Judgment reverse, fear of change, entrapment, remaining in prison, refusal to make decisions. What did I say? Success means postponing something until it goes away. Task to dust yourself off and start over. Is that what the hangman's for? Because that kind of makes sense with the rest of these. The hangman reversed. Or no, the hangman upright, my bad. The hangman upright. A new look at the world. The quest for deeper meaning. The ability to push old views aside. To stay calm in seemingly hopeless situations. Admit you don't know anything. You'll begin to know more. And then your next card is Page of Pentacles. I don't really have anything for that one. That's just what it is. Page of Pentacles upright. A time for stable growth, gaining self-confidence, appropriate pride, happiness in a circle of friends, able to wait, becoming mature, haste makes waste. And then you have the Eight of Swords. Okay, this makes sense. This is like a death and rebirth kind of situation, except it's not fully. You're not shedding old skin, but you're getting the sense that you have. You know, so you're like, I'm going to continue trying. I'm going to get better. I'm going to do it. Stuff like that. I don't want to say this, but I kept thinking about the Devil card, and I was like, is he addicted to something? Like, and I don't want to say that because that sounds really mean. And I'm not like, oh my god, crack cocaine, you know? He obviously doesn't do crack cocaine. You have the Eight of Swords reversed. It's just, I can't get it out of my head. Falling back to old habits. Eight of Swords reversed. Playing the victim, feeling powerless, avoidance, listening to advice but not following it. What the fuck did I say? I said he needed to listen to somebody. You needed to listen to somebody, Colby. And he didn't do it. He's not listening. Eight of Swords reversed. Playing the victim, feeling powerless, avoidance, listening to advice but not following it, not seeing the obvious solution, mistaking imprisonment for security, feeling intensely only when suffering. If you crawl, you won't fall. Task to rid yourself of shackles. Are you okay? Why are you doing this to yourself? Why do you feel like... Why are you so deep in your own head? Like... I feel like there's a lot of, like, being stuck in my own head in both of these. I guess that's the life of content creators, isn't it? And then you have the Five of Pentacles upright. Letting go of the superficial conversations, a strong soul, growth through obstacles, endurance, humility, openness. Success sometimes grows out of failure. What? Did he have a girlfriend? Like, was he dating someone seriously? Or just dating someone at all? I have such a sneaking suspicion. There's such an underlying tone. Holding off on a decision. Having, like, how stressed did this decision have him? Like, why? What? How big was this decision? Because I don't see this decision ever being made. Unless it's in between the Hierophant and the world here. Because holding off on a decision, being a bitch because of it, and then suddenly the world's in your hands? And then falling back into old habits, not listening, thinking. How do I interpret this? The cards be saying stuff, and I'm like, damn, how do I interpret this kind of deal, you know? Because it's like avoiding a decision, being a douche because of it, the world is in your hands, you're defensive, you're falling back into old habits. You think you started anew, but you're not listening to somebody. I'm not sure how to interpret this. You need to listen to who is telling you something. I don't care if you think, I do not give two shits, Colby. If you think this is the worst advice you've ever heard. Like, if you personally think, nah, that's not gonna work, listen to it. Listen to it. Actually go through with it. Maybe even think about it sometimes. I don't know. But you need to listen. Like, that is, like, the most prominent here. Like, you, Colby, you need to listen to whoever is telling you something, because I think it's going to help you more than you think. Like, I genuinely wonder... No! Did he pass a decision up? Did he pass a decision up? Did he pass something up? And someone was telling him not to pass it up and he did because he didn't like it? Or, like, he didn't think it was necessary? Or, like, something he didn't want to do. But he passed it up because he didn't want to do it. But somebody was telling him to do it anyways, whether he wanted to or not, just because of whatever. And he said, no, I'm not going to do it. Did he pass a decision up? That makes more sense than not being able to make a decision. Next time... Hold on. I'm going to pull more cards because I'm interested. And though this message is pretty clear, I'm not sure of the situation. Because... One card. I ain't reading all that. I'm sorry. Actually, let me see what's in here. Oh? Wait, what the fuck? Are they like mirror twins? Okay, I have a question. Are Sam and Colby like soulmates or something? Or like they were meant to meet? Because tell me why I just pulled the exact same three cards in the exact order I got for Sam. What? That's why I said, are they mirrored? Like, because I wouldn't normally go through that pile, but I just wanted to see, like, what the message was. It wasn't anything spectacular, don't worry. And I don't think it revolved. Oh. Ace of Cups. Okay. Oh! Page of Cups. Okay, I'm gonna pull tumor cards. That's what I'm feeling. Oh. Damn! Connor! No! No way. Colby, what are you not doing? Are we? No freaking way. Oh. No way. Sorry, I was really surprised. What are you not doing, Colby? No fucking way. Are they, like, going through it together? No. Sorry, I was really surprised by this card. I'm gonna leave the last two out. I'm gonna leave the last two out, but I'm not gonna read them unless I need to. So you have the Ace of Cups upright, Death reversed, Page of Cups upright, Four of Cups reversed, and Six of Swords upright. Ace of Cups is about bounty, prosperity, your cup is filled, like, you are pleased, you're happy, you're living life, stuff like that. Then you have Death Reversed. That's why I keep saying, like, what is he not doing? because Death Upright is about death and rebirth, the ending of a cycle, starting anew, coming out from the ashes. Death Reverse is about continuing a cycle, one that you shouldn't be continuing. The Page of Cups Upright. Shit, I forgot Page of Cups Upright means. Whoopsies. What are you scared of? That is what I just heard. What are you scared of? Stop being scared. Everything's worked out for you so far. Why wouldn't this work out for you? This is Page of Cups Upright. Page of Cups Upright. New vitality of love, good intuition, creative fantasy, willpower through strong instincts, feeling hidden connections. A time of spirituality. Behind each weakness lies a strength. What? And then you don't trust anybody. Why? What happened? Why are you so sad? Why are they both this way? Why don't they trust anybody? There has to be somebody, right? I feel like my life would be very lonely if I thought I couldn't trust anybody. Oh, you know what? It's content creator life. I bet I know why they feel this way. Six of Swords Upright. Where did it go? Aww. Okay. Six of Swords Upright. Trust. Able to count on people for help. Being safely carried through life. A rest after conflict. Returning to calmness. A new start. Confidence. If you know your goal, you'll find your way. See? What did I say? My life would be so lonely if I couldn't trust anybody. But what I'm getting, or like, what I'm understanding... Stagnant, defensive, not taking the inner journey. Okay. There's two things. He either passed up a decision or he needs to make a decision. Either way, do not be scared. This is more cohesive than Sam's. Don't be scared of this decision, okay? This isn't a hard one. It's right in front of you. You... are... protected. You have come this far in life. Both of them have come this far in life. There is no reason for this decision to be an even worse outcome. Like... there's no reason for you to be this scared over a decision. Everything's worked out so far. It'll continue working out. You have... the universe is on your side. They want you to be just as happy, you know? Like, their goal is never to harm you. Or... hurt you in any way. Okay. Now, this reading is for Sam and Colby jointly. I just did separate readings for them. Hold on. Now, this reading is for Sam and Colby jointly. I just did both of their separate readings, one for Colby and one for Sam. Both of them had relatively similar messages, I would say. But for the most part, yeah. So this is Sam and Colby's reading jointly. Let's see what Spirit has to say. Spirit is getting tired. So am I. Let me reshuffle really quickly. I just got a gust of cold air. Uh-oh. I'm not going to take that because I wasn't asking a question. I'm also just reshuffling the shuffle. Okay. Oh my god. Ow, my arm hurts. Oh my god! What the hell? Hi, Kit. I'm doing a tarot reading for Sam and Colby. Queen of Swords upright, a woman? Oh, hi! A woman. There's a woman. Ah, okay. Triumph through challenges. Okay. Okay. Bye, Kit. I didn't even feel this card fall out. What? Oh, dude. Defensive? Why? Okay, damn. They want me to get this shit over with. I'm pretty sure this is all I'm gonna pull because I'm at my limit when it comes to reading justice. Who hurt you? Why is justice on the table? Who mistreated you? Who did what to you? Aries what? Aries. It is Aries season. Okay, we have the Magician reverse, Strength reverse, Queen of Swords upright, Seven of Pentacles upright, Seven of Cups upright, Ten of Wands upright, Ace of Cups reverse, Two of Cups reverse, Nine of Wands upright, Six of Wands upright, the Hermit upright, and Justice upright. Damn! And then we have the Sun at the bottom of the deck. So I'm just gonna pull that. I don't know if this will be correct because I have used a lot of energy, and a lot of these cards are ones I already know the meaning to, so this should be quick. You have the Magician reverse, which is basically you don't think you're gonna have a chance, but you are. You have the strength, upright. Oh, dude, I'm fucking struggling. Okay. Magician Reverse is basically, you don't think the world is at your feet. You are the underdog. You think you're going to be super, like, you think it's not going to work out. That's why you have strength reversed here, which is weak. You're not into it. You're not good at it. But you're getting it done. You know, nitty gritty stuff. And you have the Queen of Swords upright, which I typically read as, like, a woman. Oh, dude. I'm fucking tired. Okay. I need to fucking snap out of it. Queen of Swords. Queen of Swords. Queen of Swords upright. Harmony, reason, sense of justice, diplomacy style, comfort and ease, charm, understanding, balance, tolerance, support, makes contacts easily. If we all know each other's faults, we would find it much easier to forgive one another. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Moths might be a big thing, because you have a bunch of moths here. Seven of Pentacles is growth through triumph. Then you have Seven of Cups, which I will look up right now. Seven of Cups upright. Vital forces in the unconsciousness, the awakening of forgotten or concealed energies, trust, unexpected help. Good things come to those who wait. Yeah, this is triumph through challenge. And then you have the Ten of Wands, which I read as, like, everything is on your plate. You've taken too big of a bite type deal. Ten of Wands, upright. Courage, willingness to take on responsibility and risk, not afraid of big tasks, enjoys testing limits, willingness to start over. Only by risking failure do you learn the secret of success. Well, they certainly did, because you have the Ace of Cups here, which is like, whatever risk you took on with the Ten of Swords, the Ten of Cups, the holy fucking shit, everything but the card. Whatever you took on with the Ten of Wands here did not end well. Like, it was a fucking failure, and it caused a ripple, like, a rift is what I'm looking for in their relationship, or a relationship with somebody, because you have the Two of Cups here reverse, which is, like, not a good relationship, and then you have the Nine of Wands upright. Let me do Nine of Wands. Alertness, foresight, calm, self-knowledge, recognizing your own achievements, keeping a watchful eye out of a position of strength, no need to prove yourself. Need a helping hand? You'll find one at the end of your arm. You got there, though. You got there. And then you have the Six of Wands upright. I'm trying to make this as quick as fucking possible, because I'm so tired. Six of Wands upright, decisive action, self-assuredness, admiration, overwhelming victory, a talent for organization, enthusiasm, an open heart, grace, deserved reward, self-confidence. It's not what we wish for, it's what we truly believe that counts. And then you have the Hermit, which is about going on the inner journey, exploring yourself, understanding yourself, reaching out, getting out of your comfort zone. And you have Justice upright, which is basically, damn bitch, karma got you, didn't it? And then the Sun upright, which is like happiness, harmony, love, joy, stuff like that. This just seems like a journey of their career. Like, they started out, they got there, they made success, they took a risk, it didn't go well. Maybe they had like and like a off and on about it between them. It's like, we shouldn't do it. And then you have the Two of Cups, which is like a rift in relationship, disharmony, stuff like that. But you got through it in the end. Like, they're still marching on. And then you have the continuation of that where it's like, okay, we're back on our feet. Let's do this. They went on it. They did it. And it ended up good. Yeah. Sam and Colby, that is all I have for you for your tarot reading. If the last part of that is not what you expected or it doesn't make sense, please forgive me. That is my fault. I get really, really tired extremely quickly when I do long-winded tarot readings like this. And I can normally, depending on the size of the reading, can still only do like 3 or 4. Like, even if it's a small reading, I can still only tap out at around like 5. Because it takes a lot of effort and a lot of energy for me for some reason, and I don't know why. So, Colby, make that decision. Sam, you're gonna be okay. Okay? Like, I think my biggest thing for both of them is, like, you're gonna be okay. It's not... It's not gonna fall. Okay? You are safe. The universe is on your side. Continue taking risks. Continue doing what you're doing. Continue being you. Get back up on your feet. No matter what happens, get back up on your feet. Okay? That is all I have for you, Sam and Colby. Thank you for, I guess, letting me do a tarot reading, even though you didn't know I was doing one, so. I feel like that fucking hamster where it's like, you know. Here, let me show. Dude, I am tired. Like, extremely, extremely tired. Like, dude. Sorry, my friend just tweeted something and I was like, oh, you know. Sorry, looking at my friend's annotations. Yeah, I am extremely tired.
Stop, dude.
Oh, Jesus. Sorry, I was watching an Isaac Y video before I... Or it's not an Isaac Y video, it's a Sophiliac video. Stop! I was watching yeah, it's a whole thing. Hashtag unsubscribe, why is it trending? Oh. What? I'm fighting God. Real. Guys, I'm gonna end stream after this. I am tired. Like, that took a lot out of me. Like, actually, though. Like, oh my gosh. And I even put on my jewelry and everything today to make sure that didn't happen, you know? Because I didn't want it to happen. Because it doesn't make a fun stream if I'm fucking, like, you know? Hee. Look at my hair. Oh wow, it got worse. Oh dude, I have like 9 minutes left. Ugh. My tummy hurts too. Bruh. I've been in so much pain recently, it's so weird. I've never had this much pain before. I honestly just assumed that I had pissed off a demon or something because I was watching The Conjuring. Not The Conjuring, I was watching the... We investigated The Conjuring House with Sam and Colby. before I was in immense pain for the entire time. And I made a joke how I was like, man, these demons don't scare me. I'm gonna beat the fuck out the air, you know? And then, yeah, and then I was in extreme pain, like, for a week. Pulled my back muscles while driving. Now, how you do that, I don't fucking know, but I did. Yeah. It's a whole thing. Oh my god, apparently the bad vibes I've been feeling are severe psychological distress. Sure, guys, just reading. Reviewing my slop. Doggy. Sorry, there's a dog. Leave it to me to be like, doggy. But dude, I'm so... Oh, my friends texted me. Let's see what my friend said. Oh. Let's see what my friend said. You can see the passcode in my phone. That's fine. It's not like anyone's gonna steal it. And know that I... Oh, man. Bruh, this is so sad. My friend just, I think I said this earlier in the stream, but I just found out that my friend actually gets off at 11 instead of 7, so now I have to have my mom drive me to his house at 11 p.m. Which is so nice. Yeah. Or I could sit in Walmart for like 4 hours, just fucking... annoy him, you know. Let's see what he says. I said, I just told my mom she didn't have to drop me off at 11. Crying face emoji. Why would you say that? Crying face emoji. I'm asking him to call off. Fuck, where's that emoji? Guys, this is what it's like texting my friends and me. Where the fuck is it? Yeah, my texts between me and my friends are between me and them and God. What? Can this motherfucker reply? Larry Croft added to his story. Wow, thank you. He said, let me check my points. And I might be able to. Guys, I'm taking everything off. Let's go. Whoa. Okay. Bracelets. Coming off. Dude, you can tell I'm tired. I feel like you can see it in my eyes. Also, my fucking ears are starting to hurt. Let's see what Larry posted to his story. Jesus Christ. What the hell? Sorry, I just saw a photo of Gronk and I thought it was really funny. Boy, he better have them points stacked up. Let's see what is on my Instagram. Nothing much. I can't show you guys my Instagram, by the way. I wish I could. We'd have a very fun time seeing all of my things. But, it's my personal Instagram. So, like, you guys can't, see what it is because it has my face on it. Dude, I'm so cute. Sorry, I'm looking at my older posts. I'm not as cute as in my older posts, but I am quite adorable in my newer posts. Sometimes I don't want to be a faceless content creator simply because I like that I'm adorable, but I do not look that good, trust me. And I have quite a bit of acne at the moment, so it's just nicer to wear a mask than anything else. Spin. I'm doing my merge minor. What? You're doing what to the minor? Doing my merge minor at the moment. I freaking love playing this game. Like, it is so freaking fun. Sorry guys, I'm merging the minors. Yeah, cause that's a fucking sentence. Sentence and a half right there. Drop. We're beating the shit out of the, did I win? I didn't win, guys. Uh-oh. I lost! Ross Simmons, the fuck? I don't want no Ross Simmons. Get the fuck out of here. Sorry guys, merging the miners again. Oh, we might beat the boss. Nope, not today. I thought I got more gift stuff, but I guess not. Merging the miners. Oh my god, guys, it's been 3 hours. Oh my god, I forgot to stop recording. Guys, it has been 3 hours, on the dot. I'm 19 seconds over. What? It's 9:58. I had a couple minutes, actually. I got 2 minutes before it's, 10 p.m. I normally end at 10. But guys, I'm going to end 2 minutes early, because I'm extremely tired. It's been a 3 hour stream on the dot. So, farewell, everybody. I hope you had a lovely whatever. Hope you enjoyed my Sam and Colby reading. Sam and Colby, I'm sorry if the tarot reading was actually not correct. My apologies. That's all. My throat hurts. I'm tired. I want food. Yeah.